So in the first chapter we cover the operational research overview. In the operational research we are solving the problems related to the business, industrial type of problems, okay, transportation type problem. Okay, so in the operational research we are having the different types of models. So by using these models we can solve the problems, or we are by solving this type of problem we are getting the optimal solution. So what are the different models present in operational research, like linear programming model, winning model, then transportation problem, inventory model, game theory model. So these are the different types of models present in operational research. Okay, so in that first we discuss what is a linear programming problem. We discuss what is a linear programming. So the model which is used for optimum allocation of scarce or limited resources to competing the products or activities under such assumptions as the certainty, linearity, fixed technology and constant profit per unit is a linear programming. So linear programming is a powerful quantitative techniques or operational research technique designed to solve allocation problems. So next is a linear programming indicates the planning of decision variables which are directly proportional to achieve the optimal result, considering which within which the problem is to be solved. So LPP, that is a linear programming problem, which means finding the optimum solution or a minimum or a maximum represented by the function of variables or parameters called as the objective function. So this objective function is denoted by z and having the subjected functions, that is set of linear equations or inequalities equations called as a constraints. Okay, so this type of problem we called as a linear programming model. So the operational research problem, as I said, the operational research are used in the business type problems, industrial type problems and transportation problem. Okay, so if we are considering this type of problem, so we have two objectives. Okay, for that particular problem we are having the two objectives. So minimize the cost or maximize the profit. Okay, so in a business related we require minimum cost and maximum profit. Okay, so this is our main objective, and all these objectives are subjected to the what are resources we are using. Okay, so this is called as our constraint. And what is the, so these are the different resources. Okay, and for that particular resource how much requirements are present. Okay, so this is called as our constraint. So this is our one objective function, that is the first equation is our objective function. Then next is our constraint. So among these three constraint, the first two is called as a linear structural constraint, and then next last equation is called as a non-negative constraint. All these values x and y are the resources, or it may be some product values. Okay, all these x and y values are always greater than or equal to zero, so these values are not a negative, so this is called as a non-negative constraint. Clear? Also we discuss there is a two equations. So first equation is called as a equality constraint, that is in that equality sign related to the left hand side also and right hand side also. So this is a equality equations. But in a second equation, we have a 2x plus 3y is less than equal to 14, or 2x plus 3y is greater than or equal to 14. So this type of representation is called as a inequality constraint. So this type of equations we can solve by using a operational research. Then the next part is a complete solution to an LPP problems comprises of a following steps. So there are two main steps are present for solving the linear models: formulating problem to a proper mathematical form, and the second one is solving the problem graphically or algebraically. Okay. So अगर हमें problem solve करना है by using the LPP problem, first we require the mathematical form. Formulating the problem in the mathematical form, that is, how to formulate the problem in a mathematical form by using the objective function, constraint, and non-negative constraint. Okay, so here, and then this formulation of problem or a mathematical form we can solve in a graphically or in a form of algebraically. Okay. This one example, the second example. Here, a resourceful home decorator manufactures two types of lamps, says A and B, and both lamps go through the two technicians, first a cutter, second a finisher. So lamp A requires 2 hours of the cutter's time and 1 hour of the finisher's time. So the cutter has a 104 hours and finishers has a 76 hours of available time each month. So the profit per lamp A is 600, and per B lamp is a TSH 1100. So assuming that he can sell all that he produces, how many types or how many of each type of lamp should be manufactured to obtain the best return? So the solution for this problem is formulation of the mathematical model of the problem. So if we are having one example how to solve this type of example in a linear model, so first we require to formulating the problem to the proper mathematical form, and then this type of problem, formulated problem, we can solve by using the graphical or algebraically. So first we require the formulation of a mathematical model of the problem, of that problem. So for the clear understanding of the problem, first we have to construct a table. Okay, so in the constructing a table, we require we have given values is the lamps, then we have a cutter, finisher, and then we have a profit. Okay, so there are two lamps are present, A and B. For two technicians, first a cutter and second is a finisher. So lamp A requires 2 hours of the cutter's time and 1 hour for the finisher. Okay, so lamp A has 2 hours for cutter and 1 hour for the finishers, and the cutter has a 104 hours A lamp A requires 2 hours of the cutter time and 1 hour for the finisher time. Okay, and the cutter has 104 hours. Okay, so here the cutter has 104 hours and finisher has a 76 hours of available time each month. So available time is what? 104 hours for the cutter and 76 hours for the finisher. Okay, per Okay, so the profit per lamp A is 600 and the per B's lamp is 1100. Okay, here. So here they are not giving the B. Both lamps go through two technicians, first a cutter and second a finisher. Lamp A requires 2 hours of cutter time and 1 hour for the finisher time. So here also the lamp B has a 1 hour for cutter and 2 hour for finisher. In this type of problem, the decision, what are the decision variables? So as I said, For solving the linear programming problem, we require these components: decision variable, objective function, constraint, non-negativity, restrictions, divisibility. Okay, so for that problem, that is this example, what are the decision variables? So let the decorator manufacture x1 x2 lamps of type A and B. Okay, so for the A and B, we are using the decision variables are x1 and x2. Then what is our objective function? So the total profit in a so what is the total profit has is a maximized. So this is called as a objective function. So 600 and 1100 is our max value. Here we are considering only 6 and 11. So x1 and x2 are the decision variables for a particular A and B, and we have to find out the profit, that is the max value. So this is our objective function. Max z equal to 6x1 plus 11x2. Then next is this objective function is subjected to the some constraint values. So what are the constraint? So the manufacturer has, so this manufacturer has a limited time for manufacturing the lamps. So there are 404 hours and 76 hours are available for cutting and cutter and finishers. So the total processing time is restricted here. So for the cutter, 2 hours and 1 hour. For and available time is a 104 hours. Similarly for finishers. Okay. 1 hour and 2 hours. For the available time is a 76 hours. Okay. So here we require the 2 hours. So 2 and 1, 1 and 2. And so this is called as a final constraints are 2x1 plus x2 is less than equal to 104 and x1 plus 2x2 is less than equal to 76. And there is a non-negative constraints are x1 comma x2 is greater than equal to 0. So this is a formulation of a linear programming problem.